stands and holds on to the strap with her life. She is trying to block out the man beside her, bragging about his status update. She can't bear to look at her reflection in the window, so she closes her eyes. Her right hand has become raw holding the strap, so she switches to her left hand. But that doesn't make anything better, so she grabs on with both hands. The stop for her station is still far away.
Father? What's up? I'm fine. Just fine. How are you and Mi-chan?
But Aya is lying.
Miss Okamura, there are reports today that weren't filled correctly. We can't have you making simple mistakes.
We're both doing well. Fine as always.
But her father is lying too. His boss yelled at him, and the cat, Mi-chan, is old and does nothing but sleep lately.
I was actually in the area for work. And I thought we could have dinner together, for old time's sake.
Sorry. I'm still at work right now.
Aya seems to have outgrown eating with her parents.
Mr. Carrot, Mrs. Cherry, Mr. Mushroom.
Aya, food's ready.
Huh? Coming!
As a young girl, Aya always seemed happy, no matter what she did. When she ran, when she ate, when she talked, when she sang, she was always cheerful. As her mother got busier and busier with work, it was mostly her alone with her father. Aya seemed lonely, so her father got her Mi, the cat. Aya and Mi-chan became the best of friends. Before long, Aya started school, and her happiness started to come from her friends and not her family. Aya's father slowly started becoming less important to her.
I'm very sorry.
She started resenting the fact that he was so ordinary. Aya's father knew that these were all signs that she was growing up, and that brought him joy. At the same time, it made him very lonely and sad. Aya started working and realized her desire to live alone. And now, she tries to do everything on her own. I am getting older and older, but I remember all those things from that time. If I had one wish, it would be to see him and Aya one more time.
Father? What is it now? No way. Yeah, I'm all right. Take care of yourself, Mom. Bye.
Honestly, I will miss Mi-chan. I don't think I would be this sad if any other human had died. Is that a strange thought?
It's not strange. Mi-chan was our family, after all.
There are a lot of things Aya and her father have forgotten. On the day Aya's father promised to protect her, she made a promise as well. I have to protect my dad. The day Aya joked about her parents made her feel bad. So she made dinner for the first time. The first night she started living alone, they both cried a little because of the loneliness. When Aya's father said he was in the area because of work, He had actually bought both of them a nice dinner for two, and was standing outside her apartment.
Is this the first time you've cooked for me?
It's the second time. I had a dream about Mi-chan yesterday.
I had a dream too.
Really? You brought back memories.
Yes, good memories came to me.
What kind?
When you were little, you didn't have wrinkles between your eyebrows.
What? I can't believe you're saying that. You're covered in wrinkles. I'm home! I came to see your new girlfriend, Dad. Oh, so cute and small.
Just like when you were little.
I was bigger than that. Oh, is that Mom? Coming!
No matter what happens, happiness will always prevail. But you two already know that.